the strength lies, she'll snatch it from you.
Amen.
And then you'll be like old Samson, and in death, that's when you got to gain your strength back. But then it's too late. It's too late then. So brother, stay out the lap of Delilah. Because Delilah set the trap for you. I don't care how beautiful she looks.
That's right.
I don't care how good she's smelling. Stay away from her.
Amen.
Praise the name of our God. I know you're looking from the rooftop and you see Bathsheba bathing. You better turn and look the other way.
Amen.
Praise the name of our God.
Preach it.
Bathsheba won't get you into some trouble. Yes. And you'll find yourself committing adultery or fornication.
That's right.
And you might end up having to murder somebody over Bathsheba. You got to be careful. But if you get into the Word of God and allow the Word of God to talk to you, you'll stay away from a whole bunch of stuff.
Amen.
Yes, you will. You women will get them no good men and get them out of the house.
Amen.
Praise God. The one that's laying around don't want to go to work and provide for his family.
Preach it.
Praise the name of our God. Oh, yeah. You'll get rid of them. You'll boot them out the house. Tell them I can no longer be with you.
Mm-hmm.
A man that will not provide for his household is worse than an infidel.
Amen.
The Word of God. Yes. Amen. And we get in the Word of God and serve God with fear and rejoice with trembling. Some of our lives will turn out a whole lot better.
Amen.
Sometimes we ask, well, God, why me? How did I get in this situation? How did I get in this dilemma? Because you're hard-headed. Sometimes you don't take the time to read the Word of God and let the Word of God talk to you and counsel with you. But the Lord tells us to fear the Lord, to rejoice with trembling. Isaiah 50 and at verse 10. How y'all feeling?
All right.
Feeling all right?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Isaiah 50.
Isaiah 50.
And at verse 10.
Verse 10?
Yes, sir.
Who is among you?
So now you got to look and consider who among you. Who among you? Look out among yourselves and say, who among you?
Who among you that fear the Lord?
Fears the Lord. Who fears the Lord?
Good question.
And I'm not talking about just saying we fear the Lord.
Amen.
But who really fears the Lord?
Amen.
You got to consider this thing. Look in the heart of your mind. Examine yourself and say, do I really fear God?
That's right. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Do I really know who God is? Because remember, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. We want to have wisdom, we got to start fearing the Lord.
Amen.
And we must be taught how to fear the Lord. How to reverence God. How to honor God. We got to fear the Lord. Who among you fears the Lord?
That obeyeth the voice of his servant.
That obeyeth the voice of his servant. Now it goes beyond just fearing the Lord. Now he said, who fears the Lord and who obeys the voice of his servant?
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Because then God will send you people that will speak the mind of God, that will tell you the heart of God, and you then must have to be obedient to the voice of the servant.
Amen.
When he's instructing you and telling you things that you must do in order to be right with God, you got to obey it.
Got to.
Amen.
Because God loves his people, and he's not going to leave us in the dark. Amen. He doesn't want us to be ignorant. So he's going to come and tell us to remind us to know how to fear God. Know what to do to be right with God. Yes. And we have to have a willing heart and a willing mind to be obedient to the voice of his servant. Who among you feareth the Lord?
That obeyeth the voice of his servant.
That obeyeth the voice of his servant.
That walketh in darkness.
That walketh in darkness.
And hath no light.
And hath no light.
No light.
Let him trust in the name of the Lord.
Trust in the name of the Lord.
And stay upon his God.
And stay upon his God. See, when you don't fear the Lord, when you don't listen to the voice of the servant, you walk in darkness.
Yes,
oh, yes, you do.
Amen.
You walk in darkness.
Amen.
Because his word is a light to our pathway. His word is here to guide the way. If we don't hearken to the word and the voice of God, we're walking in darkness.
Amen.
Y'all know what happens when you walk in darkness? You don't know where you're going.
Amen.
This church gets dark too, boy. If we cut all these lights off in here, you wouldn't know where in the world you're going.
Amen.
Because you're in darkness.
Amen.
Next thing you know, you're walking trying to guide. You've been right into that organ. Instead of the toe on the pew. Because you're walking in darkness.
Amen.
So you bring hurt and pain to yourself when you walk in darkness.
Yeah.
But if you walk in the light,
hallelujah,
even as he is in the light, you can find your way clearly. The Lord said, who walketh in darkness
and hath no light?
And have no light.
Let him trust in the name of the
Lord. Let him trust in the name of the Lord.
Yes.
You got to put your trust in God.
Amen.
Jeremiah, the 5th chapter.
Thank you, Lord.
By the help of the Lord, get a few more scriptures out of the way. By the help of the Lord, I'll come to my close. Jeremiah, the 5th chapter.
Jeremiah 5.
Yes, sir. And at verse 20.
Jeremiah 5 and verse 20.
Yes, sir.
Declare this in the house of Jacob.
He said, declare this in the house of Jacob.
And publish it.
And publish it.
In Judah.
In Judah.
Saying.
Saying.
Hear now this.
Hear now this.
O foolish people.
O foolish people.
And without understanding.
And without understanding.
Which have eyes.
Which have eyes.
And see not.
And see not.
Which have ears.
Have ears.
And hear not.
And hear not.
Fear ye.
Fear ye
not me.
Not me.
Saith the Lord.
The Lord is speaking.
22.
And he said, you foolish people who have ears and hear not, eyes and see not. That's a terrible thing to be alive and still be a dummy.
Amen.
Praise the name of our God. That's a terrible thing. To be alive and to be able to grasp understanding and still be called a fool.
Amen.
Because that's what the word called them. Anybody that lacks wisdom is a fool.
Amen.
Have ears, but they hear not. Eyes, but they see not.
See not.
Not listening, not paying attention. Have no vision. The Bible calls them a fool. Oh, foolish people who have eyes and see not, ears and hear not. The Lord asks him the question, fear not
me.
Fear not me. So the Lord is now talking to his people, telling the preacher to publish it among the people and to ask him a question. You don't fear me?
My Lord.
I, being God, you don't fear me? Prophet Isaiah said, Jeremiah, look out among you. Who feareth the Lord? Ask him a question. And the question needs an answer. Who fears the Lord? Then the Lord has to come to his people through the prophet Jeremiah and say, fear not me. Somebody's not fearing the Lord. Fear not me. I'm God. And you don't fear me? Keep reading, brother.
Will ye not tremble at my presence?
Listen to what the Lord is asking the people. This is some powerful stuff here. Never mind if I take my time this afternoon.
Take your time.
He said, fear ye not me, saith the Lord. God is talking now.
Yes,
and when God starts talking, the whole earth must be silent before the Lord.
Yes.
Incline thy ear to what God is saying. The Lord would always, in the New Testament scripture, say, he that have an ear, let him hear. What the Spirit is saying to the church. See, it takes more than just this natural ear to hear God. When he said ear, he's not talking about this ear. But he's talking about your understanding. Are you understanding what God is saying? Are you listening with your spiritual mind? With your spiritual ear? Are you opening up to what God is saying in the inward man in order for God to speak to you? Well, God is talking now. And he said, fear ye not me, saith the Lord.
Will ye not tremble?
Will you not tremble
at my presence?
At my presence?
Which I placed the sand before the bounds.
Check out what the Lord is saying. Now he has to bring us to his track record and start giving us a history of who he is and what he has done. Will you not tremble at my presence, which have placed the sand for the bound of the sea?
By a perpetual decree.
By a perpetual decree.
That it cannot pass it.
That it cannot pass it. In other words, the Lord said, I made the sand to be a border for the sea, that it cannot come past this. I made the sand to be an outline to the sea. And I commanded the sea, do not pass this sand. We're talking about God Almighty. With a perpetual decree. In other words, that word that he spoke when he created it in 2015, that decree still stands.
Amen.
And that water don't move past that sand.
Amen.
So from the beginning of time, when God said, don't move past the sand, that sea still ain't moving. And no matter how many generations come and how many generations go, when I die and my children come, and then my children die, and their children come, and they die, and their children come, and then they die, guess what? The decree still remains the same.
Amen.
And that water will not move past that same, because it's been decreed by the Almighty God. Do you see how powerful this is? To the sea even obey him. When the Lord came and they were on that ship and the water and the wind was boisterous, and all the Lord did was come and step on the sea and say, peace be still. Hey, looking at the Lord and see how he calls the sea to stand still, how the wind had to cease, and they had to stand in amazement and say, what kind of man is this?
Yes.
To hold even the seas and the winds obey him. The power of God. To where even the wind has to obey God.
Yes.
The sea got to obey God.
Hallelujah.
How much more us, his people. Even the waters fear God.
Mm-hmm.
And they stand there by a perpetual decree that it will not pass that sand. Keep reading, brother.
And though the waves therefore toss themselves.
And though the waves therefore toss themselves.
Yet can they not prevail.
Yet can they not prevail. Keep reading, brother.
Though they roar.
Though they roar.
Yet they cannot pass over.
Yet they cannot pass over it. Keep reading, brother.
But this people have a revolting
and a rebellious heart.
They are revolted
and gone.
Neither say they in their heart.
Let us now fear the Lord our God.
That giveth rain.
Both the former and the latter.
In his season.
He reserveth unto us.
The appointed weeks. Of the harvest.
The Lord looked at his people and said, they will not say in their heart, let us now fear the Lord our God. The Lord will say to his people that they know that they don't fear him, but they won't even say in their heart, let us now fear him.
Amen.
Won't even come to bring themselves to a place to say, let us begin to reference God.
Amen.
And he called them a revolting and a rebellious heart within the people. We don't want to be found in this number.
Amen.
We don't want to be rebellious and revolting against God.
Amen.
No, we want to be the ones that stand in awe of the majesty of God. We got to realize who God is.
Amen.
Because we don't want to see God in the light that those folk in the scripture saw. The long suffering of God has waited for the people for so long. He's waiting for the people, allowing grace and mercy to be extended.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, he is. But do you know that even in the scripture, the Lord allowed things to happen in order that fear would fall on the people?
Amen.
And we don't want to get to this place with God.
Please, Lord Jesus.
We don't want to get to this place with God, when God got to make things start happening in order for us to fear him.